in January, when you guys were there, the insurrection happened. And I'm just wondering what that was like for you, because clearly there were a lot of issues around this related to race and how the insurrectionists were treated as opposed to Black Lives Matter protesters. Did you feel yourself having a bit of PTSD in having conversations with your with the housemates?
No, I mean, what I felt was not just January 6th, the insurrection, but also with Breonna Taylor a year ago, George Floyd a year ago, Black Lives Matter exploding, where we saw people of all different races, skin colors, backgrounds, identities coming together to fight for justice, is that a lot of the stuff that we talked about on those original 13 episodes actually, you know, were valid and actually kind of foreshadowed a lot of stuff that's happened.
There was a lot back in 92. I mean, the evolution of understanding about racism and systemic racism, it just wasn't there really. And so I'm fascinated to know if the housemates that came back together with you in January kind of, you know, acknowledged that you were ahead of your time, you were more perceptive than they were.
Yeah, were they more on your side? Did they say, you know what, you were right, Kevin?
And did they even apologize?
Yes, the answer is yes to those things. And it started actually last year with my brother Norman, you know, who is the first openly gay brother person, period, to be on a national TV show. People forget that. He's very important to TV history as well. And, you know, he hit me when the whole George Floyd incident happened. And he said, my God, you know, Kevin, I've thought about this for years, but you were right about everything, you know. And I don't want to be right about everything. I want justice. I want equality. I want inclusion. I want, you know, freedom for all people, no matter who we are, to be able to move wherever we are in our society without feeling like we're going to get killed just because of our race or our gender or our gender identity. And so, you know, it's not something that I'm gloating about, you know, because the tragedy is as much progress as we've made in 28, 29 years. The fact that we're still dealing with this with George Floyd and Breonna Taylor, January 6th with the white supremacists who showed up in D.C. says that we have a long way to go as a country. Literally, when we were taping the first 13 episodes, the LA exploded and we watched it on TV in the loft. It's actually in one of the episodes that we shot. And for that to be one bookend and then January 6th and Trump and George Floyd and Breonna Taylor to be the other bookend, again, says that we have a lot of work to do. But I hope, Charles and Harvey, that when people watch these episodes and they see the conversations that we're having, you know, that people understand that one of the ways that we move this country forward, move ourselves forward, is to be open and honest to listening to people who might have different perspectives on things. We, you know, it's not just racism, it's sexism, it's homophobia, it's all of it. We can't make peace with hate. That's unacceptable. It's unacceptable.